Mickey Bay, one of your fighters? What do you think about Mickey Bay?
Mickey Bay is a good fighter.
Very talented?
Very talented, very talented, very smart, and pretty slick and clever. You know, I'm expecting for him, I'm looking for Mickey to win the title. Because when it's title time, that's when I'm finna bear down. I'm finna bear down with it. All the game is over.
It's business.
So let's get past this fight right here, and then we can take care of our business, stay on the case, and run our place.
How many champions have you made so far in your career?
Well, I made Floyd champion first.
Okay.
I made Floyd, I made Stevie Forbes, I made Floyd, Stevie Forbes, Chad Dawson, and I've made Delahoy my champion about three times.
That's a lot of champions.
Yeah, it is a lot of champions.
Steve Forbes is a great person, very talented as well.
Yes, he's very talented. Stevie Forbes is a talented fighter. He looked very good. Matter of fact, the same guy he had fought, he fought with Roger the first time, and everything came out neutral. It came out, there was a draw, then Stevie won every round.
You have a great boxing mind, so does Roger. What does that mean when both of you guys work together to train Floyd? How does that work? What does each one bring to the camp?
Well, I can't say what nobody else brings to the camp. I can only speak about me. You know, I can't speak what nobody else doing. My thing is that mainly, you know, he said he don't want to be getting hit. So that's why he brought me back.
And we saw the results in the last two fights.
Thank you.
Untouched.
Thank you.
And I think one time Canelo hit the rope and Floyd was looking.
Exactly. You know, it ain't just like that with them. We got Maidana. We call him MacDonald.
Why?
We call him MacDonald. Because he ain't nothing but a piece of beef. That's all. He's there to be laid. He's there to be hit and laid.
But he's strong. I mean, he's been in a roll. I think he has three or four knockouts in a row.
Who cares, man? That don't mean nobody's great because they got three knockouts. I mean, you know, I'm just telling you the truth.
Yeah, no. His record is 34-3 with 31 knockouts. Floyd, if you won the lotto and won $100 million, what would you do with all the money?
What would I do with all the money?
Yeah.
He already got that. You don't know. Don't worry. He already has it, reader.
Well, what if he got another 100?
Oh, man.
Let's see, what would he do with it?
He'd give me 50.
Okay.
One thing about it, I got a lot of grandbabies.
Okay.
And hey.
Spoil them?
I would spoil them to death. I'm going to spoil them anyway because I got enough money to spoil them. But I'm going to continue to spoil them.
But you wouldn't get your private jet or
Oh, none of that.
No yachts for you? Nothing
like that? No yachts, none of that. I'm going to get me a big old house though. A big, big house. So I might change. Right now I'm going to change up, probably get me a 5 or 6,000 square foot home.
That's huge. You got horses?
Right now, no, I ain't got horses. But I want to get me a big old house. And for my grandbabies and things to come and do their thing, do whatever they want to do. You know, because
if you had to make up a nickname for JLeon Love, what would you go with? What's JLeon? JLeon, what's a good nickname for him? Your brother Roger said the real deal. What would you go with for his next fight?
The man is rough and tough. And he knows his stuff. He ain't never been scared by a bum.
That ain't a bluff. God damn it.
What do you think about JLeon? Good fighter, good dude?
I think JLeon is a good fighter. I think he's moving up. He's using his hands more. He's letting his hands go more, a lot more than he was doing before. And he's letting his hands go now. That's a good thing for him right there. Because you get guys out like that, letting your hands go. That's what I used to do.